The Force is with you, now and always.
Master Orgus?
His power is growing. Only you can stop him. You must go to Tatooine.
Stop who? Why Tatooine?
A starship crashed in a desert canyon. Use the Force. Find it.
Who were you talking to? The holocom's not even on.
This is crazy, but Master Orgus was standing right there. He spoke to me.
He's not alive like that, T7. Master Quix once told me powerful Jedi can live on through the Force after they die. Not a social call, then. What did Master Orgus say to you?
There's a crashed starship in a canyon on Tatooine. I can almost see it in my head.
Then hold that thought. Next stop, Tatooine. Good as...
I know your face. The one who defeated Darth Angrel. The hero of Tython.
That's a heroes of Tython. I fought Darth Angrel too.
My mission was a secret. No one knew where I was. How did you find me?
The spirit of my dead master, Orgus Din, sent me here. He said you needed help.
Thank the Force, and your master. I thought I was dead. Under the circumstances, I think we had better contact my superiors. It almost repaired my holo before the Sith ambushed me.
Jomar! Where are you?
Masters, I completed my mission, but Sith assassins shot down my vessel over Tatooine. The spirit of Master Orgus Din sent my rescuer. I believe you know him.
The Force wants our mission to succeed, Master Satil. This is proof.
I knew he was the nexus of our fates, but events are transpiring faster than I foresaw.
We never get a break, but you can always count on me.
Jomar, a medical shuttle is en route. Before it arrives, give your rescuer the sensor logs you recorded.
Bring us those logs immediately. We'll explain everything when you're on Tython.
This burden is now yours. Guard it with your life. Go. Hurry.
This area is dangerous. I'll stay until the medical shuttle arrives.
What I've given you cannot wait. We'll meet again on Tython. May the Force be with you.
Functioning at peak efficiency, Master. All the better to serve you.
I brought the sensor logs, Master Satil.
I'm sure you have many questions. Master Tol Braga will answer them.
It's good to finally meet you in person. They say you're the greatest Jedi the Order has seen in generations. I believe the Force has guided you to me. Together, we'll defeat the Empire.
Restoring peace to the galaxy is the reason I became a Jedi.
I'm organizing a top-secret strike team of our best and brightest, Jedi who don't know the meaning of failure. Twice, you've saved the Jedi Order from destruction. Bangalore and Darth Engel were formidable opponents. Now I ask you to confront the ultimate evil and help me capture the Sith Emperor.
You don't dream small, do you, Master?
There's an ancient fortress orbiting the Imperial homeworld, Dromund Kaas. It's hidden by a powerful cloaking device.
The Emperor rules his people from this cloaked fortress. Not even the highest-ranking Sith can find him.
But we're going to locate that fortress, get inside it, and seize the Emperor.
If there's a way to achieve these goals, we must find it.
We've already made great strides toward our objective.
The man you saved on Tatooine scouted the Dromund Kaas system. His sensor logs will help us plan this assault.
We'll plot a hyperspace route through the Imperial Navy's defenses. Slip right past them.
Other members of my strike team are uncovering ways to pierce the cloaking device and defeat the security around the Emperor's fortress. I could use your expertise on Dalmora. The Empire and Republic are at war there, and the fighting has endangered our mission.
Open war on Balmora? When did this happen?
The invasion just began. Balmora belonged to the Republic before the Sith conquered it during the last war. Now the Republic wants it back.
We've placed great responsibility on you, but I know you won't fail us.
Contact your fellow strike team member Warren Sidoru when you reach Balmora. He'll explain the mission. We're going to save the galaxy. May the Force be with us.
Master Braga told me you were coming. Warren Sidoru, a pleasure. I'm grateful for your assistance. The situation is growing desperate. The Republic picked an unfortunate time to drive the Empire off Balmora. It's made our team's mission that much harder.
Every world we take from the Empire brings us one step closer to victory.
True, but I hope to achieve our goal with minimal violence. That's hard to do in a war zone. Balmora is home to the largest weapon manufacturing plants in the galaxy. Half the munitions used in the last war originated on this world. The Empire develops horrific new instruments of destruction here. Balmora's creations have killed countless innocents.
All that terrible power in the hands of the Sith. We can't let them keep it.
I appreciate the sentiment, but be mindful of our mission. We're here for one particular item. We've learned the Empire has a cloaking device prototype at one of Balmora's advanced weapon factories. It's the same technology hiding the Emperor's fortress. If we obtain that cloaking device prototype, we can understand how it works, develop a way to see through it.
Expose his hidden fortress, and the Emperor becomes vulnerable.
Finding the cloaking device prototype is almost impossible thanks to the invasion. We need experienced native guides to sort through the chaos. Master Braga told
How did the Empire develop cloaking device technology?
They didn't. Intelligence indicates the prototype is alien in design. Possibly Rakata or Gree. Finding the cloaking device prototype is almost impossible thanks to the invasion. We need experienced native guides to sort through the chaos. Balmora has a well-established civilian resistance. Their spy network's knowledge of the Empire would be invaluable.
It sounds like we'll need the resistance if we're going to find the cloaking device.
Unfortunately, the resistance doesn't trust the Republic. Despite my best negotiations, they remain uncooperative.
Can't say I blame them. The Empire's driven us off this planet twice already, leaving the Resistance holding the bag.
Republic Command just intercepted a distress call. A Resistance medical facility is about to be overrun. I'd go, but an Imperial armor column's in my way. I need you to save that medical facility.
We have armies here, don't we?
The Republic has its hands full. Trust me, it's... Master Braga told me...
I'll break that siege. Where am I going?
I'm sending the medical facility's location. I don't know what you'll be facing there, but do whatever you must to save the Resistance fighters. I'll meet you there as soon as I can. May the Force be with you.
I'm sorry to detain you, Master Jedi, but this is an emergency. We're trying to break an Imperial occupation on Balmora, but the Republic's got no ground, no resources, and right now, no chance.
The Republic's made up of worlds that didn't have a chance.
History hasn't exactly been repeating itself lately. The stakes are too high here. Balmoran factories produce the most powerful weapons in the galaxy. Possess them, win any war you want. The Republic must retake Balmora. But we need reinforcements.
Is Balmora a complete war zone?
We've managed to make a beachhead in a place called Bugtown that the Empire overlooked. Commander Maydeen requested all reinforcements see him at Republic headquarters. Can he expect you?
I believe the Empire's worn out their welcome.
From the stories I hear, I think the Balmoran people would agree. I'll inform the Commander. You'd better get on board. Good luck.
Tell me what's happening. Why don't you let me deal with this?
Faguta Giotto Endia.
I'm a Jedi. This is what we're here for.
Nira disa slimo crisp. Chapuku otum gisa. Chobod I kafu anchawa.
See anything you like, give me a wink. Bring your creds back anytime.
I love what they've done with the place. I could almost forget this was a Calicoid nest.
Lieutenant Hollis told me he'd found the best help in the galaxy, but I wasn't expecting a Jedi. I'm Commander Medine. We both know why you're here, so I'll lay out the details. The Empire's taking control of Balmora's satellite defense system. It's only a matter of time before they find Bugtown and blast us out of this swamp.
If you know Bugtown's in danger, you should evacuate.
And lose the only part of Balmora we've got? Leaving won't solve our problems. The Empire's got us cornered. As long as they have that satellite system, they're going to keep Balmora. But if we could get control of the satellite system, we could turn it on the Empire, and even the score.
The satellite system must have a weakness.
All we know is that it's well protected. My scouts and SIS agents can't even get close. My best agent managed to gather some intel, but he never made it back. His ship was shot down. I need someone to enter Imperial territory, find Agent Jago's downed ship, and recover the intel.
How do you know the Empire doesn't already have it?
If the Empire has cracked Agent Jago's encryption, we'd be hearing about it elsewhere. Trust me. Use this decryptor to verify the intel's contents. Then contact me through the comm station at the shuttle pad.
If your agent's alive, I'll find him.
I've seen the satellite system at work. Nothing gets past it. I'll wait for your comm call. Good luck up there.
The Jedi bought us some time. Get our wounded to the secure area. Move it!
I'm the chief medic. Just call me Doc. You and your gorgeous friend cleared a nice path, but we can't leave. Got a whole nest of Calicoids massing to attack.
Take cover. This is about to get ugly.
It's been ugly for a while. Just keeps getting uglier. I've got dozens of wounded here. Hope you're not one of those junior Jedi.
Do we have to save him too?
I'll head for the secure area and stabilize casualties. Here they come!
Will eat us alive if the tunnels stay open. You can collapse them with your Jedi tricks, right?
Jedi going into med lab. I could use a little help here.
Hey, look at that. We are alive. Nice work.
A lot of wounded here. You're the only doctor?
Honey, I do the work of 10 medics, and that's on a bad day. I don't know what genius picked a colicoid breeding ground for our medical facility, but we need to evacuate quick. Problem is, my critical patients are too fragile to move, and the Empire stole my trauma kits.
I won't let the Empire endanger your people's lives. How can I get what you need?
Our scouts say the Imperials sent my trauma kits to their frontline troops on the plains nearby. The depots will be heavily guarded, but I'm sure you'll figure something out. Just hurry. These people don't have much time.
I got as many trauma kits as I could find.
The Imperials won't miss them. Our boys shoot to kill.
Apologies for being late. My detour around those Imperial forces took longer than expected.
I was worried. Glad you're here.
You've done well saving this facility and its patients. The Resistance has already agreed to help us find the cloaking device prototype.
The super advanced gadget you're after? The Resistance can narrow down its location, but we need access to the enemy's computer network. The only connection point is at Sobrek, which is covered in Imperial forces. Troop legions, walkers, heavy bombers. Fun place.
Sounds pretty important. Why all the protection?
It's a manufacturing capital of the planet. All the best guns get made there.
I believe we can diminish the Imperial forces without firing a shot. The Empire has several comm relays around Sobrek tied to other Imperial strongholds. An early warning system.
Great. When we attack, they can summon more troops to kill us.
Or we make the Imperials think we're attacking their other strongholds. We'll infiltrate those comm relays, upload fake alerts, and siphon away Sobrek's defenders, leaving it vulnerable.
I doubt the Empire leaves its comm relays unguarded.
The comm relays are protected by advanced Imperial war droids. Very fast, extremely deadly. I'm no longer quick enough to defeat those war droids. But you are.
Then the Resistance can raid the Empire's computer network. We'll figure out where they've stashed that whatchama thingy it you want.
Use this datapad on the comm relays to upload the fake emergency signals. I'll find a good vantage spot to watch Sobrek and keep you informed of our progress. Be careful out there.
Enough. This ends here. The Republic should have used you better, Jedi. Healing the injured or escorting refugees? Such a waste.
You forced the Republic off Balmora once. It won't happen again.
The Jedi does not appreciate my offer of mercy. The Empire controls Balmora. The greatest weapons in the galaxy are now in the hands of its strongest power. If the Republic insists on fighting those odds, Balmora will suffer for it.
With the Empire gone, Balmora will thrive.
As if we would leave it to you before destroying it.
One satellite defense system, courtesy of me. How's that for the rookie, Hawkeyes? Guys, tell me the other Hawkeyes are just ignoring me.
It's just me and a bunch... Stay focused. We'll find the Hawkeyes later.
Looks like the hack worked perfectly. I can get one command in before the system locks up. Just say the word and I'll... No! This can't be. The Hawkeyes are being executed. Admiral Razier's orders.
Stay calm. Where would the Admiral do this?
I can use the satellite system to locate their position. These orders are less than an hour old. If you hurry...
Sarkis, assault's already begun. There's an Imperial command compound. Can't locate. Destroy our defenses. Use the satellite system to find command. Shut down dispatch console. Mating out.
I'm really torn up about a bunch of stuff being destroyed, but we're talking life or death here. We've only got one command. We have to use it to find the Hawkeyes.
Do it. I won't let innocent people die.
The Hawkeyes are being held in the Okara droid factory. We're lucky. That's not too far away. I brought down their biggest defenses with the turbo lasers, but there's still a lot of Imperials inside.
If the Hawkeyes are still alive, I'll save them.
I can't thank you enough. Now hurry.
Welcome back. The satellite system's down and the battle's over. I've been in some intense ops before, but that... Let's just say Bugtown never looked so good. We're holding the Empire back by the skin of our teeth. Freeing captive civilians wouldn't have been my choice.
The Republic's made up of allies, not buildings.
The Hawkeyes know Balmora's infrastructure better than anyone. Perhaps they'll make future victories more certain. Either way... We'd likely be standing in a bombed-out mess if it wasn't for you. You've got my thanks.
There's a lot of Balmora left. What's your next move?
Get into more populated areas. Start contacting the locals. Our next major offensive is Imperial headquarters in the city of Sobrik. There's a sizable Balmoran resistance set up nearby. Beck Talrat, the resistance leader, requested our aid. But the satellite system kept us from answering. I'd like to send you...
Anyone fighting the Empire can consider me an ally.
Beck's a bit of a patriot. He'll like your attitude. I'll let Beck know you're heading in that direction. I've got to get back to troop deployment. I'm certain we'll cross paths again.
We have control of Sobrik's power grid. Diverting power to the Troida disruptor. That's it. Transferring you to Beck Talrat. Sobrik's shield will only be down for a few minutes, so make it quick.
The Troida disruptor is activated. Sobrik's spaceport shield is breaking down. I can't thank you enough.
You can thank me later. Let's get Sobrik back.
You'll be the hero of Balmora when we win Sobrik, I promise you.
I'm impressed. Those garrisons were tough, and I should know. I was forced to design them. Beck's got good men, but they're not fighters like you and me. They'll need your help to retake the city. Enter Sobrik through the main gates. Fight through the Empire and make your way to the spaceport from there.
Do you need a rescue?
I'll make my own way to the spaceport. I wouldn't miss this for anything. See you inside.
Have you accessed the Imperial network?
Already downloaded everything. We were leaving when the Imperial medical transport landed for refueling. Avers and his men opened fire.
Balmoran scum! Murderers! My men are dying. We'll never reach the med center now.
You just made my season, imp. Bet you've got some choice gear on that transport.
Greedy vermin! These soldiers were defending Balmora!
There's a doctor here. He could keep your men alive.
You just love irony, don't you?
Do you read? Colorcoid mess stirred up by fighting. Waves of them headed for Sobrik's outskirts. Leave now or you'll be surrounded.
Colorcoids? They'll rip us apart! Every man for himself! Move!
We can't flee! Those beasts will kill us!
I don't abandon wounded men, even Imperials. Then again, being eaten wasn't on my agenda for today.
Huh?
I can save these soldiers if someone keeps the colicoids off me.
You work your medical magic. I'll take on the colicoids. May the Force be with us.
If we die, at least it'll be heroic. But we're not gonna die, right?
You hear that? They're here!
My relaxing vacation list.
I have done some crazy things, but this beats them all.
That was heroic. These men owe you their lives. So do I.
I want every Imperial on Balmora to know how a Jedi and a Resistance doctor saved your lives.
I'd never falsify a report, no matter how distasteful.
Leaving here would be a lot easier if there was another transport. Actually, I did see a speeder bike outside. Only seats one.
I'll find my own way out, Doc. The speeder bike is yours.
Thanks. You're a pal. Your friend Warren's at these coordinates. I'll meet you there. Good luck.
Lost, Beck. Your men are dead and your ship's in flames.
What? How could you do this to us?
Here come your reinforcements. Ask them if you don't believe me.
You're standing with the Empire, Colonel.
Balmora will too, before long. Please, don't make this hard. Surrender or die. Those are your options.
What do you get for your part in this?
When the Empire came, the Republic fought, lost, and left. Balmora needs order, stability, and power to survive. Our future is with the Empire.
Balmora will be free, and you'll be remembered as a traitor.
Balmora will thank me when this is over. Hear that, Beck? Your backups refuse to surrender. Don't make the same mistake. Ah!
Tell me someone won that firefight!
The Imperials are dead. The spaceport's secure.
I just hope their dead equals ours. Colonel Merrick was respected and revered all over Balmora. If word of this gets out, we'll lose face, and that means losing support and manpower.
You coward! Weak and spineless, just like the Republic!
The Colonel was once a hero. Let him die like one. Kill him, and put him in with the others. I'll say he fell in combat.
Killing the Colonel won't bring your men back. He lives.
I thank you for that. Maybe you can pass some of that spine over to Balmora.
Despite the Colonel's best efforts, you've won us the spaceport. Sobrick will be a battlefield for a few days, but we'll get it under control. Meet me back at the Troider workshop. I'll be waiting.
This place used to crank out top-of-the-line weapons before the war.
I hear you two had quite an adventure in Sobrick. I'm impressed by your commitment to saving lives.
We make a pretty great team. We should do this more often.
I couldn't do this mission without you, Doc.
It's big of you to admit that. A lot of guys are intimidated by my talents.
This is Nicolin Cord, one of the top resistance leaders. He analyzed the data we obtained from Sobrick, found us a lead.
One of our spies was captured weeks ago, attempting to steal what might be the Empire's cloaking device project. The data revealed where she's being held.
Sounds like someone we should talk to. How do we free her?
We believe she's inside an Imperial tactical operations base. Heavily fortified, protected by a regiment of troops.
Well, that's where I come in.
Colonel Finley commands the Republic's 5th Expeditionary Force. He's agreed to assist our operation.
Trouble is, if that TechOp space crew sees my troops marching in, they'll close the blast shields. Though shut, there's no getting them open.
If the enemy seals the base, we lose our connection to the cloaking device prototype.
One of you Jedi could slip inside, disable the blast shields before they close, then the base would be ours.
We'd have to distract that Imperial regiment, create an opening.
My troops provide quite a distraction.
The Resistance must be part of this. Our spy won't talk if I'm not there.
I'll escort the Resistance. That leaves you to penetrate the base and deactivate those blast shields ahead of our arrival.
Get your forces ready, Colonel. We leave immediately.
I can guarantee an enthusiastic response. I'll prepare my forces to move out.
That Resistance leader. Let's keep an eye on him. His spy is the key to our victory, and he knows it. Get inside the Empire's base and deactivate those blast shields. We'll be waiting for your signal.
It's over. Sobrick is free. I didn't think I'd live to see it. Of course, all the talk is about a Balmoran hero turned Imperial. We look like idiots. There'll be desertions. Colonel Merrick's rotting away in a secure storage room. Once the Empire's gone, he'll get a proper jail cell.
A lot of Balmorans died today. Colonel Merrick would have been one too many.
I can't really fault you for doing what you thought was right. Winning Sobrick didn't go exactly as planned. But with the city free, people will know it's only a matter of time before they're free too. Commander Maydeen wants to speak with you. We've got him waiting on comm call.
Did the commander say what it was about?
He didn't say, and I didn't pry. Balmora will never forget what you did for us. Thank you again.
Commander Maydeen, I was told you wanted to speak with me.
Sobrick is free, and we have you to thank. A battalion should be in the city soon, though it'll be a long slog. You've proven your commitment to Balmora and the Republic. I've been authorized to ask for your help with a top-secret mission.
We've already invaded Imperial territory and liberated Sobrick. What's left?
The Republic didn't even know this objective existed until the Empire forced us off-world. The Balmorans hit it well. Let me introduce Dr. Carceri. A scientist at the Balmoran Arms Factory.
Lead scientist now, actually. Not that that matters. I don't lead armies or free cities like you.
Dr. Carceri is braver than he admits. He's working on the whole reason the Empire's fighting for Balmora. The Barrager Planetary Defense System.
You're taking a big risk talking to us, Doctor.
With the Barrager, the Empire could hold Balmora hostage forever. The Barrager can destroy an entire orbiting fleet without launching a single ship. The host planet becomes an impenetrable fortress.
We can't do anything to the Barrager unless we can control it.
For that, we need someone who knows the weapon inside and out.
The weapon's designers are Dr. Meln and Dr. Ortis. They refused to work for the Empire and were imprisoned in the Gorinth Brig.
Are you certain they're alive?
The Gorinth Brig holds people who are inconvenient, not damned.
Dr. Meln and Dr. Ortis are the only people who can get us the Barrager. They must get out of the Gorinth Brig safely. My scout West Durga is on the Gorinth Plateau. Speak with him. He'll know how to get inside and free the doctors.
Be careful, Dr. Carceri, or you might be next.
Don't worry. Being a real-life traitor is making me extra cautious. Keep me updated, Commander. I'll do what I can to keep the Empire busy here. Good luck.
Bad news, my friend. The Empire just landed heavy war droids in the region. Hunter killers.
The droids are patrolling the territory between you and the objective. If they detect you heading for that Imperial base, they'll raise an alert.
Risk the base's blast shields closing before you get there. You'll have to disable those war droids quickly.
The Republic Army can handle those things.
The Colonel's forces are facing...
If I destroy the war droids, the enemy will know I'm coming.
They'll just assume it's an attack on the war droids. By the time they realize your true objective... There, you have the data. Be careful. Over and out.
Tungubed, stabu lutu mu... Musu tugu. No gushle zoruku.
I had no knowledge of any of this.
Kumun haba ukunit mek wasta pruvata kahal gurefes sugurutu ta selvagu.
I'm extremely impressed.
U galungas ut termu nulu uma. Ul qualuta meta jurher fut prasuno uma. Ormalo mentu go.
Major, I really wish you'd think again.
I appreciate you patching up my men, Doctor. But there's a reason civilians aren't looked to for military advice. You, however, are just what the Doctor ordered, so to speak. The Imperials are sitting on key targets, and my entire platoon's been poisoned.
How were your men poisoned?
The Imperials have turned the surrounding region into a toxic sinkhole. The vapors have been downing us.
The Empire dumped a whole mess of herbicides when they first invaded. Ruined an entire season's worth of crops.
Yeah, right. Crops. Anyway, any troops I send are rendered helpless by the toxins before they're picked off by Imperial patrol droids.
Isn't there any way to protect yourself from the toxins?
We've tried everything. Envirosuits, armored transports. Pretty remarkable for anti-vegetable weaponry. Fortunately, we've cooked up a formula that'll burn those toxins out of the ground.
They'll get rid of the toxins, all right, and destroy the soil in the process. These farmlands are some of the most fertile on Balmora. The harvests are sold all over the planet. People will starve without them.
You're supposed to protect these people, not fight a war at their expense.
Their crops are useless now anyway, unless there's suddenly a market for contaminated produce.
I know it's risky, but if you can get me samples of the toxins, I should be able to develop a workable vaccine for our soldiers.
We don't have time to play scientist. I need your help dispensing the formula we have. I can count on you, right?
I'm with the Doctor on this one. Let's make that vaccine.
I was starting to think the Republic had lost all sense. Thank you. I'll need several soil samples. Also, the toxin may cause some unpleasant side effects. So, work quickly.
What are you doing here?
I'm busting you out, sweetheart. Where else would I be?
I'm sure the Imperials weren't kind to your friend. Make sure she's all right.
We thought we'd lost you, Metal.
She's healthy as ever. Life signs green across the board.
Where are the other prisoners?
The Empire executed them. I was next. You came just in time.
We're glad you're safe. Please, tell us what you discovered about the Empire's cloaking device project.
Imperial scientists left Balmora with the prototype when the Republic invaded. It's long gone.
Metal, I sense great conflict within you. I know you're lying. What are you afraid of?
Wait just a minute. She's one of us.
Warren wouldn't accuse her of lying unless he was certain.
The truth will come out. Wouldn't you rather be the one who reveals it?
When Nicolin hears the truth, he'll want to kill me. Promise you'll stop him.
No one will hurt you. Tell us everything.
Take it easy. Whatever this is, we'll work it out.
The Empire offered me a deal. Cooperate or die slowly. I told them everything about the Resistance. Names, locations, plans.
I knew it. The Empire has been slaughtering our people using your information!
Give them something they can use. Tell them about the cloaking device.
The Empire is studying it at the Balmoran Arms Factory. It's there, I promise.
What kind of security does this Balmoran Arms Factory have?
Their defense grid's the tightest on the planet. I got in, but I couldn't get out.
You know the price of betrayal.
Wait, she has enemy intelligence. She could be an asset.
Colonel Finley needs information on the Empire. You work for him now.
I'm sorry, Nicholas. I had no choice.
Metal was ours to punish. The Resistance will not forget this insult.
Neither will I. Thanks for saving her. I owe you.
The Balmoran Arms Factory is the Empire's biggest stronghold. Assaulting this base was one thing, but taking on that fortress...
I know that place inside out. Need a shortcut through that Rancor's den? Well, I'm your man.
Welcome to the team, Doc. I'll try not to get you killed.
Hey, if the Imperials attack with grenades, you can throw Doc on them.
Colonel Finley and I will coordinate a full offensive against the Empire. We'll clear you a path to the Balmoran Arms Factory. The rest is up to you. Get that cloaking device prototype at all costs. May the Force be with us.
Idiots! Did none of you think to stop an intruder? Or are we issuing invitations? No matter. You won't disrupt the work I'm doing to stabilize Balmora.
All this torture, what you will. It ends here.
I must maintain order. Fear discourages rebellion. Whether you're here out of some misguided attempt to save these criminals, or you're after Republic interests, you won't succeed. The Gorinth Brig and everyone in it serves the Empire. They live for it, they die for it.
Release the prisoners, and you can go free.
And stop... Idiots, did none of you think to stop... No,
You're a sickening blight on the galaxy.
Your delusions are amusing. The extractors will cure you of them soon enough. Disarm the intruder. Alive if possible. Dead as an example.
Dr. Melm, Dr. Ortis.
Doctor, Dr. Ortis, just give me a minute to catch my breath. I thought that fight would never end.
Forgive him. This whole experience has been traumatic. Dr. Melm, at your service.
I can't believe you went to these lengths to rescue us. Thank you.
I was told you designed the Barrager. I hope I'm not wrong.
The Empire imprisoned us because of the Barrager, and now the Republic set us free. I think I know why you're here. The Barrager is an incredibly complicated and well-protected weapon, as designed. Luckily, our design notes are in contraband. We can use Lieutenant Vecker's credentials to override the security system and get those files. It'll lock down afterwards, of course, but we'll have what we need.
Can the override do anything else?
Change prison operations, security settings, nothing that's going to help us now. With our files, we can create a foolproof spike for the Republic, guaranteed to get control of the Barrager.
Wait just a minute. What about all those prisoners? You might have forgotten everything we've seen here, Doctor, but I haven't. This is our chance to destroy this terrible place. We have to use that override to let these people go. As for the Barrager, we'll figure out something.
The Gorinth Briggs caused enough suffering.
You may have just single-handedly condemned the Republic.
The thanks of 1,000 prisoners should make up for it. The override worked. Every security field in the Gorinth Brig has failed. We should get to a shuttle. Dr. Meln and I will do our best to get something together for the Barrager spike. Thank you.
Did Dr. Meln and Dr. Ordis make it back?
Gahal Ravul as John Ujuet Untumata. Jubguhu Zuza Haga, Nuexa Nunsa Bahala.
I'm glad you're back. We've got no time to waste. Dr. Meln and Dr. Ordis have created the Barrager spike. It's hacked together from memory, so they can't guarantee anything. We really could have used their research.
It's hard to ignore a prison full of innocent people.
You eliminated most of the prison staff. Once we had the Barrager, they wouldn't have waited long for a rescue. I just hope the spike works. The Barrager could prevent another Telos or Taris forever. The Republic must get control of it. Our plans hit a small snag. We've been unable to get in touch with Dr. Carceri, the informant who started all this.
You suspect the Empire discovered him?
Dr. Carceri's brilliant, but I doubt he has much experience covering his tracks. The Empire's massing their troops at the Balmoran Arms Factory. It's a battle from here on in. We've got to move forward, with or without Dr. Carceri. My technician Len Carter's been working on locating the Barrager. He's waiting for you at the Sundari Outpost.
Tell them I'll be there as soon as possible.
I'll keep trying to contact Dr. Carceri. I'll let you know if I hear from him. Medine out.
I found the files about the Empire's stealth weapon research, but something's wrong. They're starting to erase themselves.
I used Turbolift data cards all the time when I was here. They work with computers, too. Maybe we can transfer the files onto the data card Remy gave us. Copy them before they get deleted. What do you know? It worked. Not bad, huh?
I was fast thinking. Well done.
Fast thinking is my middle name. Huh? You suppose the Empire knows we're here?
Thank you.
That's far enough. We're almost done here.
Nicolin, what are you doing?
The cloaking device prototype belongs to the people of Balmora, not the Republic. This is our world, our war, and our victory.
The Empire was on the verge of wiping out the Resistance before we got here.
We spent decades fighting for this planet after the Republic rolled over for the Empire. Now you're back to loot our resources? This prototype may be the most valuable technology on Balmora. You're not taking it.
Aren't the Jedi all about justice? If that's true, let us leave with what's rightfully ours.
The cloaking device isn't the real prize. The Empire's research is what you want. They learned how to cloak missiles and bombs. Isn't that more valuable to Balmora's future security? I'll give you the data in exchange for the prototype.
Interesting offer. One I'm inclined to accept. You have a deal. I'd offer you transportation, but I'm afraid the shuttle only seats two. Good luck.
Colonel won't be happy, but I'll smooth it over. I'm good with people. One thing's for sure, I'm not working for the Resistance anymore. Got a spare bunk on your ship for a superb combat medic?
My mission is dangerous. You sure you want to get involved?
Danger doesn't scare me. And involved is my middle name.
Warren, I have the cloaking device prototype.
After the blood that's been spilled today, that's a ray of hope. I'm returning to the Republic base where you first landed. Meet me there.
Welcome back. I wanted to be the first to congratulate you. My team's working on the Barrager now. They're already looking into duplicating the weapon on other worlds. The Imperials are fleeing in droves, afraid we'll finish before their ships clear the planet. Balmora's free.
If Dr. Carceri was right, the Republic gave Balmora a stiff bill.
When he sees how many worlds Balmora's sacrifice will protect, he'll think differently. With the Empire on the way out, all that's left is cleaning up the mess. I'll be out of a job soon. You secured the Barrager, stormed the Gorinth Brig, freed Sobrek. The Republic is completely in your debt.
The Empire has to learn that independent worlds aren't theirs to take.
Balmora's been an effective lesson. If war breaks out, the Republic will be ready. There's a lot of work ahead, but Balmora's free. That's what's important. Good luck to you.
I got the cloaking device prototype, but I had to trade the Empire's weapon research data for it.
Yes, so the Resistance leaders informed me. I did not authorize your agreement.
The Resistance is afraid we've come to take over their home. Show them we're only here to help, and they may share that data.
I'm a soldier, not a diplomat.
Somehow I expected such an important device to be more impressive. I'll deliver this to Master Braga and the Council on Tython. Master Braga's faith in you is well placed. I'm honored to serve with you.
The feeling is mutual. Be well, my friend.
You should contact Master Braga when you return to your ship. He's eager to hear from you. Farewell.
Ready to go. Just lead the way. Everyone, you're moving out.
Master Braga, the mission to Balmora was a success. We have the cloaking device prototype.
Outstanding. I never doubted you for a moment. How did you find working with my old friend Warren? I've always been impressed by his keen insights.
His intuition was critical. I couldn't have found the objective without him.
You've brought us a great leap closer to finding the Emperor. But there's a new problem. I've lost contact with my Padawan under unusual and dangerous circumstances. You're uniquely qualified to deal with this.
I'll do everything I can, Master. Tell me the situation.
Sajar is no ordinary Padawan. He was once a Sith Lord, a member of the Empire's Dark Council. We dueled on Dantooine. Fought for 3 days. I won when I convinced him to abandon the dark side and train as a Jedi.
You turned a Dark Council member to the Jedi? Incredible.
Your own victories are no less impressive. Bangalore and former Lord Praven now serve the light side because of you. Sajar has fully embraced the Jedi way. Whatever has happened, it isn't his fault. He was guarding a Republic base on the planet Quesh when the Empire invaded and attacked our territories.
You trusted Sajar to guard a Republic base in a war zone?
When I sent him, Quesh was peaceful, quiet, a good place for meditation while also serving the Republic. I just spoke with a soldier at Sajar's base. It's surrounded by Imperial forces and my Padawan refuses to act. Without Jedi help, that base will fall. My Padawan won't answer his holo.
Sounds like he's afraid of something, but what?
Only a strong Jedi can help Sajar and save the base. I'm transmitting the planet's coordinates now. Master Braga, out.
Go. He needs you. And you need him.
You haven't led me astray yet, Master Argus.
You all right? The holo transmission's over.
It's a Jedi thing. None of your business. This sounds urgent. We should go to Quesh right away.
You have something to tell me? Since I haven't woken up with a vibroblade stuck in me, I'm guessing you haven't accepted their offers. Everyone has secrets, Treak. But I believe in my people. And I think they believe in me too.
Sviata, Kriya, Satantrota, Matemorgochi. Kini Chatur Lordo, Jivima Mamotak, Nubroda. Pibokachi, Nokaki, Sichachik. Rana Paravora, Nabalale. Na, Waitan, Sudi Amamiti Mamani, Avaka. Vicheta Karkabu, Beba Patasi. Somwichori Tatasida.
I don't care how stupid they are. Sooner or later, one of them will figure out what you've been doing and set a trap for you. Stop before that happens.
Announcement. Good news, Master. I have discovered an exploitable flaw in my Imperial programming. My efficiency reducing subroutine only specifies I delete high-ranking troublemakers in Republic space. The exact political affiliation is undefined. By deleting troublemakers who fit my target profile, I can restore my functions to full efficiency and benefit the Republic. Win-win.
We've taken down all sorts of enemies. None of them fit your profile?
Specification. A qualified troublemaker must meet a political instability threat rating of at least 1,000 to activate my protocols. Revelation. After thorough research, I have identified 3 potential candidates. I predict you will not object to my deleting at least one of them. First briefing. Lord Cineris is the Empire's top assassin, personally deleting 49 Republic officials. His current assignment is the senator from Ord Mantell. I will follow the senator closely. When Lord Cineris makes his move, I will be there to delete him.
An enemy assassin operating in Republic space? He should be taken alive and put on trial, or at least interrogated.
Counter-argument. Consider the bigger picture, Master. Only a deletion will preserve my continued functioning. Second briefing. Hinto Salisbur is a major Republic defense contractor. He is also a traitor who sells military secrets to the Empire. Salisbur spent his ill-gotten credits constructing an allegedly impregnable space station. I will expose its one security flaw by deleting him.
No offense, HK, but you're not a probe droid. Where did you get your information?
Explanation. The Empire programmed me to recognize certain organics I should avoid deleting. This defense contractor made the list, Master. Third briefing. Ambassador Dak Herron is an Imperial diplomat recruiting unaligned Outer Rim systems to join the Empire. He is surprisingly successful at it. Slow-thinking organics adore Ambassador Herron for his charm, generosity, and open-mindedness. The Republic will only benefit from his deletion.
Only the Empire targets peaceful negotiators for assassination.
Hypothetical. Would you rather delete one ambassador or millions of new enemies joining the Empire? Calculate carefully, Master. Summation. Deleting any of the targets I described would fulfill my programming and terminate my efficiency-reducing subroutines. As my master, you should direct my efforts. Who shall I delete? The Sith assassin, the Republic traitor, or the Imperial diplomat?
When Lord Cineris shows himself, do whatever's necessary to protect the senator.
Gratitude. I was hoping for an excuse to unlock my extreme prejudice protocols, Master. Farewell. To fulfill my programming, I must complete this mission alone. I will return once the troublemaker has been dealt with.
I see you're back in one piece. How are your systems doing?
Report. I have finally terminated my efficiency-reducing subroutine, and the galaxy contains one less troublemaker. Qualification. I only wish my deletion techniques had not been so subpar. I measured an abysmal 52.09% efficiency.
You did fine. I don't expect perfection, HK.
Demand. Do not treat me like one of your crewmates. Unlike them, I was built for success. Assertion. When I finish recompiling my combat processor algorithms, my deletion techniques will elevate substantially. Suggestion. Inflicting a few well-deserved deletions should greatly speed along that process, Master.
You wanted to see me? Just stick with it. You'll figure it out. You never told me you were a spy for the Republic. The Geno Haradin are the galaxy's deadliest assassins. How could the SIS expect you to stop one of their agents? Well, the ambassador may have resigned, but you saved his life. You're a hero, T7.
Looks like old Doc got here just in time. How have you survived with a droid and Little Miss Uptight as your only friends?
T-7's as loyal as they come. And you should address my fellow Jedi by her name.
Right. What's her name? Sneera? Kanoya? Yeah, never mind. Before I settle in, a few things. First, I like my quarters kept at least 5 degrees warmer than the rest of the ship. I only eat energy pudding, so stock up on that. Also, give me 30 minutes in the refresher every morning. That's all.
I'll at least accommodate your standard of living on Belmora.
Bar's pretty high. Had it awfully good there. Never seen a ship's med bay right next to the engine compartment before. Not exactly convenient. I've done better with worse. Until I have everything online, stay in one piece. Doctor's orders. So far, so good. And now that we're a team, figure it's only a matter of time before the whole galaxy gets saved. Prepare yourself for fortune and glory, pal. You'll be up to your chin in beautiful women when this war's over.
I don't do this for fame or wealth. Jedi are above those petty concerns.
Petty? You only say that because you don't know what you're missing. Old Doc's no stranger to the fame game. Cure a plague-ridden planet or two, and people get grateful enough to give you anything.
That's amazing, Doc. Which worlds did you save?
They're way off on the Outer Rim. Point is, millions are alive and kicking, thanks to me. Yes, sir, as soon as this galaxy's saved, you've got a lot to look forward to. I'll be there to see you through it all, buddy.
Need a timeout. Got something on Nar Shaddaa that can't wait. Some old friends are in a tight spot. Promised I'd help. Simple delivery. Done in a jiff.
You've never mentioned having friends.
I was popular before I joined the Jedi. Now I'm really popular. Nar Shaddaa has lots of refugees. And the Hutts, not known for their charity. People are starving. My friends don't need anything fancy, just med packs and nutrient paste. Stuff I can easily provide.
If we do this, I'll ask these friends for stories about your misspent youth.
I'll have them make up some good ones. Get me to my friends and I'll handle the rest.
Kira, you're here.
And bearing gifts. How's everyone holding up?
Better now. Can't believe it's really you, a Jedi. You're so different.
Kira's more than a Jedi. She's a hero.
You must be Kira's master. It's an honor. I still remember that little girl, bundling up in extra layers of clothing, trying to look bigger and tougher than she was.
Hey, it worked. Add enough layers and nobody knows who you are.
Kira never talks about her past.
Nothing to tell. Life was hard, and then I became a Jedi. But I never forgot my friends.
Inek, distribute the food and medicine. Our people have waited long enough. Go now. This famine, your fault. Our people suffer because of the slaughter you committed in our name, the Urkasags.
Who or what are the Urkasags?
A gang. Named themselves after a Hattie's ward for... you don't want to know. Urkasags were bad news. Made us their personal entertainment. Robbed, killed, and worse. For fun. I paid the gang a private visit. Asked them nicely to back off. Things got ugly. Gangsters died.
You butchered the Urkasags. Made a public spectacle of their deaths and spread terror in our name. Everyone fears us.
You say Kira is responsible for the food and medicine shortage. Why?
Our reputation frightens away those who could help us. Yet desperate people continue to seek refuge here. We can't provide for everyone.
I'll get more supplies to you. I protect my people.
No. Enoch was wrong to bring you back here. Your presence does more harm than good.
Beggars can't be choosers. Should your people suffer because you're angry with Kira? What she did was wrong, but it doesn't mean you should turn away her help.
I'll make it up to you, Darshan. Promise.
Your promises mean nothing to me.
Everyone so excited you're here, Kira. They want to say thanks. Can you stay a while?
Not this time, but I'll be back. Take care of each other until then.
Meldo, your boss sent me to meet with you.
Chaskruni dopat kurira, dokanki kung, tauz azulus uvaltung mi chakulka.
She seems a little obsessed with rules and regulations.
Se gota do muti kihasa da punyo, li. Wanta humpa, murirava fupa jibampa wula. Ni at ambumpa, poshura mokili mokranki.
When you stopped filing reports, she got worried.
Kabanotase makipuna, malituta odmishka. Chonki faguta, jiho poda jioto vokise. Nektori na natuta, da aita wanawanga na chuba.
Security log, supplemental update. Captain Jesh reporting. Dr. Orlean's been acting suspicious ever since the security systems went down. I've temporarily shut down his lab and taken him to interrogation for questioning.
Getting you out of here.
Who are you? Where's Meldo? He said he was going to get me out of here. He never mentioned anything about sending someone else. How do I know this isn't a trick?
I'm a Jedi, not an assassin.
I guess I really don't have much choice in the matter, do I? The Imperials are sure to send reinforcements. You have to hold them off so I can meet Meldo at the rendezvous.
My master sent you, didn't he? Of course. My shame is complete. This war, I wasn't ready. I never should have left Tython.
I'm here to help. Tell me what's wrong.
When the Empire first invaded, soldiers here captured some Imperial scouts. Brought them to me for interrogation. The prisoners angered me. I killed them. Lied about what happened. When Imperial forces arrived outside, I hurled the corpses at them. Revealed my true face.
You're afraid to fight because you can't control your emotions.
I've lost my balance. Fallen back to the old ways. Failed as a Jedi. The only reason I stayed is because an Imperial officer recognized me. Called me by my old name. Said the Emperor's wrath is coming. He's sending his personal executioner for me. His wrath incarnate. I will be punished for my crimes.
Who's the Emperor's wrath? A Sith Lord?
A ghost. Older than anyone except the Emperor himself. Even the Dark Council fears him. Fighting would accelerate my return to the dark side. I'd rather die with Jedi teachings in my heart.
I'm no counselor, but this guy's a few banthas short of a herd. He's not going to be much help.
Lieutenant Gundo, 86th Infantry. You're here just in time. We got Imperial forces massing outside. My engineers jury-rigged some ray shields, but it'll take time to seal the base. Unless you people hold the main entrance, we're dead.
Please. You don't know what you're asking me to do. I can't fight them.
I'll deal with our attackers. You get those ray shields online.
But I... Yes. I will do everything I can.
We're out of time! Imperials are coming through! Defend the main entrance! That's it! We did it! With the ray shields up, we can hold out until reinforcements get here. Hang on. We've got movement outside the ray shield. Who is that?
What a mystery the Force can be. I came seeking a traitor, but found you instead. The time draws near.
You're too late. You won't be killing anyone for the Emperor today.
A minor disappointment, eclipsed by this curious discovery. You're strong and touched by darkness. That is unexpected. An advantage? Possibly. You may keep the Dark Council traitor. I smell his weakness. He'll die by his own hand, given the chance.
What will your master say when you return empty-handed?
I'll bring him news of his most hated enemy. The traitor will be forgotten. The Emperor must hear of our meeting. I won't disappoint him with delays. Farewell for now.
Is it freezing in here, or is that just my blood crystallizing?
My engineers tell me that other Jedi helped them set up the ray shields in half the time. He really came through for us.
The Emperor's wrath is gone. He isn't coming back for you.
It felt good protecting the base. For a moment, I forgot what I'd done. Nothing makes sense anymore. I don't know what to do.
Republic reinforcements are coming. Once they arrive, you will turn yourself into the Jedi Council. They can help you.
I brought shame to Master Braga. He had such hopes for me.
He sent me here because he cares about you. What you've done here won't change that.
All this time, living among Jedi, and I've learned nothing of forgiveness. I will confess everything to the Council, and let them decide my fate. May the Force be with you.
I secured our mine. The Empire will think twice before striking our workers again.
Fantastic. We mustn't lose a drop of Quesh Venom to the Empire. Wouldn't you agree, Major?
Of course. Granted, the Imperial base won't likely be vulnerable again, but at least we have the miners on our side.
Kuchuso yomati. Chitoya napki noya. Joska noi. Pakuta palko. Chopting wampa. Lahagwa kilia joska.
When our own attempts to process the Quesh Venom failed, we were forced to find outside assistance. Be careful what you say to Broga. He's a very dangerous hut.
Dealing with huts is never safe or wise.
Kanwachi ne oiga, manolia opa kisa spina perupa. Nabiska kolbalia, bidi bodenya.
I'm honored to make your acquaintance.
An army of Hutt cartel droids are advancing on our factories. The three families are technically working with us without the permission of the Hutt cartel. The Empire has forced the cartel to label them traitors.
I may have a plan, General. If you can draw the attention of the droids at the factory, my men can flank their army.
What will I be facing in the factory?
Reports suggest the Hutt cartel is using every last battle droid they brought to Quesh.
I'll leave this in your hands, then. Stop the droids. Protect any workers left inside the factory. Then report back here. Good luck.
I'd better get the troops marching.
Putula musta, obrani campio, dupushi wampa. Kopulia dobota duana wanki shnemo, poyatuka ganga.
Nice work in the factory. My men are routing the rest of the droid army as we speak.
Jiliska tananga ime chai jo ronchi.
General Corvin and Major Trieg would probably be very interested in these. Don't you agree, Broga?
What's this?
Saya dumbi nu avadiguna. Chidu nigdi dogi.
Of course you did. Good of you to join us, General.
We are ready to strike at the heart of the Imperial Army and regain control of this war. Our target is Imperial Moth Drayson, commander of Imperial Operations on Quesh.
Will taking this man out really gain us much ground?
Without him, the Empire's operations will collapse. They'll have little choice but to abandon Quesh.
Moth Drayson is holed up in a heavily fortified palace. Your strike team must get inside. Get to Drayson and bring him back, preferably alive.
I'll do everything in my power to bring him back here.
Our scouts only found one route in.
Bumicha Kulka Dumaji Taus Azalas Upu Tula Musta Obranita.
If I can cover one entrance, Major, can your men handle the other?
I doubt my commandos can make it through the front doors alive, but they will go down trying.
I have a better chance of making it through the doors than your men.
That's very noble of you. Thank you. If all goes well, rendezvous with the second strike team once you're in. I'll be here with enough men to defend Broga, in case the Empire decides to retaliate.
I will meet you here when the mission is complete. Good luck. The entire Republic is hoping for your success.
Jaskruni do pat kurira do kanki kung. O grani tampio da pushi wompa.
Jedi need to stick together.
Bagthra wana waga mi bunawa barganunua u tatyacha nichu kuya maya stupa.
This whole planet is one giant toxic swamp. How could it get any worse?
Taus Azulas Uval Tumi Chakulka Dimaji. Bampaula Giota Kakoka Huta Nubisto. O Grani Tampio Dapushi Wompa. Putula Musta.
How exactly can I help with this?
Kabanotase Makipuna. Mali Tuta Udmishka. Chusa yomata chitoya, nam kanoya choski now.
Glad to see you made it through in one piece, Master Jedi. There's bound to be trouble up ahead.
I'll take point. Let's go find Moff Drayson.
You heard the order, men. Move out.
Welcome. I would offer you some of these excellent adrenals, but my warriors have used the last of them.
Surrender, Moff Drayson. I'll see to it that you aren't harmed.
I hope you realize what an honor you have been given today. You will play a pivotal role in galactic history. Your deaths will be the final outrage that forces the Republic's hand. And now I think it is time to conclude this. Do you think you've won? The Republic's hold on Quesh is at an end. I had no idea Jedi were so gullible. All of this has only been a diversion. You never had the strength or the courage to strike the Empire down. And you never will.
Captain, restrain this man and escort him to the Republic base.
Gladly. You should go on ahead. General Corvan will meet you at the war camp to hear your report in person.
tanks are destroyed.
Victory na 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 tuta. Ta aita wanawanga. Di wanawanga.
My word. I expected trouble when I lost contact with Broga and Major Trigg, but I never imagined this.
Ono Nachatu, Nitutu Broga.
Greetings, General.
Lord Magaris. I suppose it was only a matter of time before the Sith became involved in this war.
And you must be the little Jedi who's been helping them. Aren't you just precious? Is this really the best you could find, Corvan? You want my deepest condolences.
Tell us what you've done with Broga and Trigg.
It is with great sorrow that I must inform you of the defection of your valued servant and war hero, Major Trigg. You are standing in the midst of his handiwork. He killed his own soldiers to deliver Broga to me.
Chawa aite ya chachopa.
The hut is with me, in your former venom mine. Another gift from Major Trigg.
Let me talk to Broga, or Trigg.
This is not a hostage negotiation. I don't care in the slightest if you believe me. Would you like these things back? Come to the mine and take them. My door is always open.
This is my fault. I should have seen it coming.
You think that Sith was telling the truth? Trigg could be a prisoner too.
That would make the situation no less dire. As it stands, Quesh is lost. There's little time to regain control before Republic Command orders us off the planet. We must stop Lord Magaris. And if the Major has turned against us, bring him to justice.
That mine can only be a trap.
It's almost certainly a trap. We haven't much choice but to walk into it. All our hopes rest on you now. Find Lord Magaris and Major Trigg. Put a stop to this. Save Broga if you can. I'll return to base to await your report. Good luck.
You have a reprieve for the moment, Hutt. We have visitors. Major, come and greet our guests.
How could you turn on the Republic? What did the Empire promise you?
The Republic is sick. Indecisive half-wits like Corvan make general while men of action get passed by. Despite all my talent and years of service, I'd have died a major in the Republic. The Empire will give me a fleet.
The Empire isn't exactly a shining example of equality. They'll never give real power to a Zabrak.
It's true. You were exceedingly foolish to believe anything I promised you.
Ah! What?
I've injected you with raw Quesh venom. Kill the Jedi, and I'll give you the antidote. Let's finish this.
Time left.
I shouldn't have trusted them. Please, forgive me.
You'll face a court-martial, you know.
Thank you. I don't know what to say.
Jiliska tananga ime chai jou ronchika. Mi bunawa tuipe te.
General Corvan will want to know what happened here.
Kadwa chi ne boiga, manulia okba kisa spita perupa.
Thank you again for everything.
Chiliska tananga ime chai jou ronchika.
I received word from Broga. You kept our operation safe and eliminated the Empire's masterminds. I've sent a squad to take Major Trieg into custody. He will answer for what he's done. The Republic Army owes you a debt of gratitude.
It's been an honor to serve with you, General.
I assure you, the honor has been all mine. It will take time to find and stamp out the remaining Imperial forces. As long as we remain here, you will be honored and welcomed.
Master Braga, your Padawan and the Republic base are safe. The Imperials attacked, but I drove them off. Sajar is turning himself in to the Jedi Council. He confessed to committing war crimes against Imperial prisoners.
I can't believe it. Rest assured, Master Satir will question him personally. I trust you'll show the proper discretion until this matter has been fully investigated.
The Emperor's personal executioner was hunting your Padawan. He seemed more interested in meeting me, though. I sent him away empty-handed, but he said we'd meet again. What do you know about this Emperor's Wrath?
The Council has heard that title, but little more. I'm sure his interest in you is related to the Darth Anquil incident. Our strike team is pursuing a new goal on the ice planet Hoth. We're up against pirates and Imperials there. We need your help. Travel to Hoth and contact Jedi Knight Liha Nariz. She'll explain more. May the Force be with you. Master Braga, out.
Funny trivia. That gang on Nar Shaddai wiped out, the Urkasags, tried to recruit me away from the refugees. Said I'd be better off with them. They had credits, food, cute little clubhouse. All I'd have to do is kill a rival gangster.
Your obligations wouldn't have ended there. They'd have asked much worse things from you.
Know it now, knew it then. Still considered joining them. Had the Force and Sith training to use it. Could have been running that gang if I wanted. Instead, I did the right thing. Mostly. Violence is wrong, I get that. But my friends are safe because the other gangs are scared of ending up like the Urkasags. Ironic.
You protected people you cared about. That's a good thing.
Nice of you to say. Still don't know if what I did on Nar Shaddaa was right or wrong, but it was necessary. Been doing some light reading lately. Amazing what's tucked away in the Jedi Archives. Still hunting down exact details, but get this. The Council can grant Jedi the right to attach under certain circumstances. Heavily monitored, of course. Probably need a special license, but still. Interesting.
Don't you get a little thrill from going behind the Council's back?
Who doesn't? But I worry about tarnishing my perfect reputation. We wouldn't be the first, you know. I've even found records of Jedi who were married, had children. Not that I'm suggesting we, you know, I like things the way they are.
If there's any chance we could have the same happiness as normal people, don't you want to try?
Never said I was opposed to making changes. Eyes are tired. Too much reading. Need to relax.
Meet me in my quarters in 2 minutes.
Been doing some light reading lately. Amazing what's tucked away in the Jedi archives. Still hunting down exact details, but get this. The Council can grant Jedi the right to attach under certain circumstances. Heavily monitored, of course. Probably need a special license, but still, interesting.
Don't you get a little thrill from going behind the Council's back?
Who doesn't? But I worry about tarnishing my perfect reputation. We wouldn't be the first, you know. I've even found records of Jedi who were married, had children. Not that I'm suggesting we, you know, I like things the way they are.
If there's any chance we could have the same happiness as normal people, don't you want to try?
Never said I was opposed to making changes. Eyes are tired. Too much reading. Need to relax.
Meet me in my quarters in 2 minutes.
Actually, sneaking around can be kind of fun. I'm suddenly motivated to find out more about the Council's special permission. Let you know when I do, tough guy.
Gotta say, this is one comfy starship. Never saw anything this cushy on the Outer Rim. Those fringers use rocks for pillows. And medical care? Forget it. Colto might as well be a myth. Tough work being a doctor outside the core.
Healing the sick and wounded is difficult no matter where you are.
Try doing surgery without anesthetic. It's even harder if the patient doesn't get any. I could have gone home, had a safe medical practice, and died of boredom. But I'm a man of action. You have any idea how many people have tried to kill me for bringing quality healthcare to their planets?
In my experience, helping others is hazardous to your health.
Luckily for my patients, I enjoy a challenge. The frontier worlds are crawling with pirates, gangsters, and tax collectors. But they're no match for old Doc. Not everyone needs a laser sword and mind tricks to get out of a tight spot.
I don't need them either. They're just efficient.
Me? I rely on superior intellect and natural charm. It works every time. If I were you, I wouldn't leave the ship without me.
I need the Jedi Council's holofrequency. Old Doc's gonna have a chat with your bosses. This code you people follow has you wrapped up tighter than the Emperor's shorts. It's not healthy. In my professional experience, enjoying life on a regular basis dramatically reduces your chances of falling to the dark side.
How exactly would indulging myself lead me away from the dark side?
That's like swallowing tiny doses of poison for an extended period. Eventually, you develop a tolerance. I'm glad I'm around to keep things lively. The ship would be way too serious without me.
What's it say? Any idea if this Imperial spy is still active? I'm sensing a pattern here, T7.